Hello and welcome to On Fire here on Daily Mirror Online. I'm Eswaran Ratnam. Our guest today is a former minister and senior member of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party, Faiza Mustafa. Mr. Mustafa, welcome to On Fire. So let's talk about the Sri Lanka Freedom Party. Following the just concluded both the presidential and the parliamentary elections, we've seen the SLFP facing a similar fate as the UNP. Is the SLFP dead now?
You can't compare the UNP. They failed to even secure one elected member, whereas we got 14 members elected. Every political parties have their up and downs. I think primarily President Maithripala Sirisena, he got the support of the United National Party to come to power. And he tried to have a working relationship with them. Then it failed. And I think that's the price the Sri Lanka Freedom Party paid, because we were in government with the UNP.
But could the SLFP not have contested independently? Why did they have to go with the SLPP?
I think when he supported His Excellency the President Gotabaya Rajapaksa, it's a common platform, it's a common pledge. So I don't think it's prudent to move away from it, because we contested on a policy and we agreed to move forward together. But as you know, in political parties, there are ups and downs, there are various comments, there are various people with various views. There's always be a section who'd say we should have contested on our own. But the party hierarchy, together with the membership, decided to contest together, and we obtained 14 seats in parliament. So I would say it's good, could have done better, but then I think we're the third largest party in parliament.
I think a lot of senior SLFP members were not even given cabinet ministerial posts. Is that some sort of concern for the SLFP?
I think you don't join a government for perks and position. It's a prerogative of the president who he appoints. We have a working relationship with the government. We are part of the government. Let's do the best for the country. And I think today, the general public is looking at what's best for the country more than political dimensions.
So you're happy with the stance or the line taken by the SLPP-led government?
If you look at the COVID situation, the COVID pandemic, if any other person was sitting as president, we would have not been able to handle it the way he handled it. So we have to be thankful that His Excellency the President handled that situation. And at least we have an economy and a country in existence where most countries, even Western countries, they couldn't face the COVID situation.
But is this government, I mean, something when this government came to office, some of the concerns that were raised were whether this government will address issues faced by the minorities or whether that is now taking a back seat?
So I think we need to move away from majority-minority. We should look at it from a Sri Lankan identity. Obviously, in any country, minority will have grievances. If you look at from the time of independence, always minorities have had grievances. So I'm sure His Excellency the President will address these grievances, and we should be able to move forward as a nation.
And the 20th Amendment is now the hottest topic in Sri Lanka, apart from COVID, of course. The SLFP has appointed a committee. You are part of that committee. What is your take?
If you look at it from the time the 78 Constitution, there have been 19 amendments. A friend of mine from UK asked me which edition. So the Sri Lankan Freedom Party is for a new constitution, and whatever issues which we had with regard to the, it should be resolved through an internal dialogue, because the Sri Lankan Freedom Party decided on principle to support the 20th Amendment. So we had issues, we decided to address it internally.
But your own members have openly come out and said that they have concerns about, why are they openly speaking if this should be addressed independently?
This is, unfortunately, some in politics like to be controversial, like to get the center stage. But when you're in a coalition or part of government and you're committed to supporting the 20th Amendment, I'm sure through dialogue and consensus is the most prudent way. As you know, all over you get people who shook their mouth out, and then that's part of our political situation in this country.
But was there a need, Mr. Mustafa, for the 20th Amendment at this point, when there's also talk of a new constitution?
I would say that look at it from the kiosk, the 19th Amendment caused. If there is no working relationship between the President and the Prime Minister, the country would lead to a situation which would be in dire straits. So constitutionally, the 19th Amendment in certain areas it was not workable because it gives powers to the President, it gives powers to the Prime Minister. And then when there is conflict, you saw what happened.
But then why did the SLFP support, or did the SLFP not expect something like this to happen, that they supported the 19th Amendment?
No, see, other than one parliamentarian, everybody supported the 19th Amendment. So I'm sure everybody supported it in good faith. Everybody thought that the country would be progressive with the 19th Amendment. But what happened was the reverse.
So these issues between then-President Maithripala Sirisena and Ranil Wickremesinghe could not be resolved?
Well, constitutionally, when powers are shared in a manner which is not workable, that was the situation. Because you have the President from one party, you have the Prime Minister from one party. Both in politics, you have different agendas, you have different views. And when there is no consensus, the country suffers. So I would state with responsibility, the 19th Amendment in certain areas was not a workable piece of legislature which needs amendment.
And the SLFP has been pushing for a lot of internal reform as well. Is there moves to actually reform the party to make it more current?
No, I think we need to reform the party. We need to address grassroots issues. And I'm sure SLFP, we have had setbacks in the past. I'm sure we will be able to address these issues and we will be able to go from strength to strength. That is my belief.
And what is your take on the way things are going with Sri Lanka at the moment, be it the economy, be it all other issues as well? I mean, are these matters that can be addressed? Or
if you look at most economies are in tatters, and if you see developed countries, they have not been able to address COVID the way we have addressed. So we should be proud as a nation how we have addressed COVID, because with the COVID situation, most countries don't have an economy left. Luckily for us, if you see the freedom of movement we have in Sri Lanka, even with COVID, because of the steps we have taken, and you see other countries, most countries are having a lockdown. So I mean, I'm sure Sri Lanka has been very progressive with the COVID situation, and obviously there are economic issues. Our tourism is suffering. Apparel industry is suffering. With all that, we are a resilient nation, and we always have been. So if we all unite, and politically I think this is a time that we all of us should work and think as Sri Lankans and move forward. And I think with that spirit, I mean, if we could work and move forward, I'm sure we'll see a better tomorrow.
You yourself are a lawyer. I mean, talk us about the judiciary in Sri Lanka. There are various opinions and views expressed about the judiciary, that some say it's politicized. Some say it's free and fair. What is your take?
We've got an independent judiciary. I'm practicing lawyer. So whatever views express, I think our judges are independent, our judges are bold, and our judges are forward thinking. Various issues are raised in a political platform. But if you take our judiciary compared to most judiciaries, we've got a very independent judiciary and a very progressive judiciary.
What of the SLFP? I mean, the SLFP, are you looking at continuing as a coalition in future as well, or are there plans to do things differently?
I think we are part of government. So at this point of time, we have a very good working relationship. So we are looking at a better tomorrow for all Sri Lankans. So I think whether you're contesting separately or together, that's a political decision which is taken when it's closed upon an election. So at this point of time, there is no issue. I think the Sri Lankan Freedom Party and the SLPP should work hand in hand for the progress of the country.
Would you say that the Easter attacks had a negative impact on the SLFP, particularly because of the allegations raised against the President?
I don't think any of those allegations are kept up. I don't think they are baseless. I think they are all baseless. Mm-hmm. But I feel obviously the question of national security, and these were used as a political issue. And I'm sure the Easter attack would have affected the SLFP at the election, because His Excellency the President was the president at that time. So I mean, in a political platform, it's easy to point fingers. But I believe that the president did a good job, and he did a best, did his best to curtail that situation and bring law and order as soon as possible.
What should this government do to bridge the gap? I mean, although some might say it's not there, evidently there is a gap between certain communities in this country. People up north, I mean, they talk differently. You see different voices coming from the east as well. I mean, to unite the country, is there something more that this government should be doing?
I think it's more than a political issue. It's a psyche for people. 30 years we were divided during the war. Then after the LTT, peace dawned. For actual peace, I mean, there should be more engagement among all communities, more than a political level, a social level. Today, unfortunately, the culture, the mannerism of communities, the other communities don't seem to understand. That is not a political issue. They are fearful. Mm-hmm. Now, for a simple reason, if you see a man with a beard and a cap, or a woman who covers her head, in certain quarters, there is a phobia. I mean, we should learn to understand why every community has their culture. I think each of us should understand the culture of another more. And I think that is very important.
But wouldn't you say that certain politicians are responsible for creating this divide? I mean, it's what they say that has actually, you know, gone viral and then made people think, okay, this man might be a terrorist or this man might
be
something else.
But if you look at politics in our country, racial politics started in the north and the east, and then it went national. So you can't blame anybody in particular. Maybe national parties failed to address the grievance of the people in the north and the east, and thereby regional parties or ethnic-based parties got an opportunity. But for me, ethnic parties is bad for the country. We all are Sri Lankans. But saying that, there would have been a reason for ethnic or regional parties to get momentum in the north and the east, where national parties have failed to address those issues. So I think governments, national parties, should address issues of all communities, and thereby we can eradicate ethnic-based parties.
And reconciliation, human rights, these were issues that the former, the UNP government rode on. Are these issues that this government would...
I think if you look at it at various stages, these issues have been raised. From the time we got independence, these have been raised. I mean, I'm sure these issues have to be addressed. And we have to move forward. I mean, all issues have to be addressed. So I'm sure this government will prudently address these issues.
And I must ask you about the investigations into certain incidents. Again, the UNP, when they came into office, their promise was that they will ensure justice for the murders of certain individuals, certain crimes, and so on and so forth. But nothing happened.
I believe we have a good judicial system. I mean, you don't need politicians to say that. I mean, the law enforcement agencies, the judiciary should take care of them on their own. So you don't need rhetoric.
But then politicians right now are talking a lot about Rishad Badruddin, and they are questioning the independence of the CID. They got, somebody.
I mean, as a lawyer, I look at things from a different perspective. I believe that the judiciary is independent. I believe that our law enforcement agencies are independent. And I'm hopeful that they would do their job properly.
So this government will not interfere in the judiciary? All
citizens, that's the expectation. And I'm sure that's what everybody's belief and their wishes.
And what is your take on the way Sri Lanka deals with certain countries as well, our foreign policy? Are we going on the right track?
I think we should be on the line. But economically, there are certain countries who are willing to help us more than others. So that should not be misconstrued. I mean, if you go to see, Sri Lanka is open to assistance from all nations. But certain countries have been helping us when we are in dire straits economically. And that should not be misconstrued or misinterpreted.
Finally, Mr. Mustafa, where do you see this country, where do you see Sri Lanka heading over the next few years?
I think it's a difficult time for all countries. I mean, all countries more than growth are looking at sustenance. There is a severe unemployment due to COVID. So let us first survive through this epidemic and then move to the next phase. I mean, it's nice to say nice stories, but I'm sure if all of us get together and get over this phase, Sri Lanka would economically prosper, and most economies are in tatters because they didn't address the COVID pandemic in a prudent and rational manner. Sri Lanka has. We have not opened our airports, where certain countries opened their airports and suffered. So I think His Excellency the President is taking Sri Lanka in the right direction. And I believe that we should have dividends of his acts and his deeds.
Right, Mr. Fiswa, thank you so much for your time, and that's all we have for you for this week.